Hi, I'm Edward O'Neill, and I'm welcoming you back to the last week, week 8 of an 8-week course on the science of learning. And I want to congratulate you on the work that you did and say a little bit about what's happening this week. This week is basically dedicated to you sharing your portfolios with each other and giving each other feedback. So you've had lots of practice in the course. And as you discussed with each other and posted your responses and responded to each other, there should have been lots of interaction, lots of opportunity for you to learn from each other. And this is the last opportunity for this particular class for you to support each other and help each other learn about learning and how it works. It's also a good time for you to reflect on what worked in this learning experience for you and what could have worked better. How can you use what you know about learning to fine-tune the kind of work that you do? So it's the end of the class, and it's the end of the first in a series of 4 courses. So you may come back for subsequent courses. I certainly hope you do. This is kind of the beginning of the story. This is how learning works and what makes it more likely rather than less. And we've been trying to help you to become a good practitioner who bases what she does in science and research and is empirical in her approach to learning. That is, you don't just give people a learning experience and cross your fingers and walk away. You try and make sure that you not only based it on sound science, but that you confirmed that the learning was happening. And if you have a very specific hypothesis about what's going to make the learning happen, you can come closer to seeing if that was what really happened. It's probably a good idea when solving a learning problem to have that hypothesis. And what if your hypothesis is wrong? What if people learned, but for some other reason? You really need kind of a plan B sometimes, or some other way of analyzing the evidence to figure out what was going on, whether the learning was successful or unsuccessful. So we hope your learning was successful in this course. We hope you were able to build a portfolio with the help of your peers that you're happy with and proud of. And now you're ready, now that you know how learning works, you're ready to learn the design methods, which are the bit-by-bit, step-by-step processes that instructional designers use to go from here's the problem and here's what I think might work to the actual details of the instruction and how you're going to create it, and is it going to be a long, slow process, or are you going to build things and test them and relaunch them and retest them? Those are things that you'll explore in the second course in the sequence about instructional design methods. But I want to thank you for coming along this journey. It's been exciting for me. I love this material and I love sharing it with people. And it really is my very fond hope that you are able to get closer to where you want to be by the end of this course. Thanks very much. It was a good opportunity for me to take this journey with you.